بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to another episode on the topic of the afterlife. We spoke about the stages of death and the stages of the day of judgment as well as the hellfire, and we began discussing the beautiful topic about paradise, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you and I the highest levels of paradise. We want to continue describing this beauty of Al-Jannah. And so the Prophet ﷺ described the soil of paradise, the ground of paradise. He said, I entered paradise where I saw its lights were of pearls and its soil was of musk. We cannot begin to imagine how this works. They asked, from what is paradise built, O Messenger of Allah ﷺ? He said, bricks of gold and silver and mortar of fragrant musk. Bricks of gold and silver and mortar of fragrant musk. Its pebbles are pearls and rubies. And its soil is saffron. Whoever enters it is blessed with joy and will never feel miserable again. He will remain there forever and never die. His clothes will never wear out and his youth will never fade away. This is paradise that we seek. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us paradise. Now in paradise you'll be walking around and you'll notice there are rivers in paradise. And these rivers even reach your palace. So the river comes directly to your house. You don't have to go find it. But when you're walking and you're exploring paradise, you'll see these beautiful rivers of Jannah. And when you recite the Quran, often you notice, Jannat, you always see, تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, beneath which rivers flow. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about these rivers throughout the Quran and give glad tidings to the people of paradise that they will have gardens or houses beneath which rivers flow. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about the rivers of Jannah, and Allah spoke about these rivers. How many rivers are there? There are many rivers of paradise, beautiful rivers of paradise, unlike the rivers of this world. So he said during the Isra wal Mi'raj, the Prophet ﷺ said, I saw four rivers flowing out from beneath Sidratil Muntaha. Two of these rivers are visible. I could see them and two of them are hidden. I asked, O Jibreel, what are these rivers? He said, these two rivers, the hidden rivers, are rivers of paradise. And the two visible rivers are the Nile and the Euphrates. And this is reported by Imam Muslim. Now, how these two are connected to our world, from paradise to this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Muslim reports that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Sihran, Jihran, the Euphrates and the Nile are all from the rivers of paradise. These are the names of the four rivers of paradise that were being referred to, according to many scholars. And this is reported by Imam Muslim. So, this is a matter of the unseen in regards to how those rivers are the rivers of paradise, or whether those are just the same with their names, or some other form of connection between the rivers of paradise and here. But those are rivers that Jibreel referred to as rivers of paradise. Another of the rivers that everyone knows about is the river of Al-Kawthar. And this is the river that was given from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a gift. It's a gift to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna a'tainaka al-Kawthar. We have granted you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-Kawthar, the river of paradise. Now, we spoke about the Hawd of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is connected to the Hawd in that this is the river of Al-Kawthar that's given exclusively to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he described it for us. So Al-Bukhari reports that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, while I was walking in paradise, I saw a river whose banks were domes of hollow pearls. Imagine the banks of which are hollow pearls. And then he said, I asked, what is this, O Jibreel? He said, this is Al-Kawthar, which your Lord has given to you. And its scent or its mud was a fragrant musk. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is a river that Allah has given to me in paradise. Its mud is made out of musk, and its water is whiter than milk, and it's sweeter than honey. And birds with necks like the necks of camels will drink from it. He also said, it is as big as the distance of a month's journey, and its length and width are equal. And its water is whiter than milk, and its scent is better than musk. Its drinking vessels are like the stars of the sky. Imagine you're drinking out of Al-Kawthar with something that resembles like as many as the stars of the sky, and as beautiful and bright. And whoever drinks from it will never feel thirsty again. This is reported by Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah. Now there are other rivers as well. So you might walk and find the river of Al-Kawthar, and maybe you'll try it out. You might walk and you'll try these four rivers that we discussed earlier. But then there's another four rivers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions. And these four rivers were mentioned together in Surah Muhammad. So what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? He says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وُعِدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ. The description of paradise which those who have taqwa al-muttaqoon, the righteous, have been promised. فيها أنهار من ماء غير آسن، وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه، وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه، وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين، وأنهار من عسل مصفى. These four rivers are mentioned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these people, the muttaqun, what will they have? They will have a river of water, the taste and the smell of which will never change. They will have rivers of milk of which the taste never changes. The rivers of wine that are delicious to those who drink, and rivers of clarified honey, clear and pure. وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ They will have all the fruits that they desire. وَمَغْفِرَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ And the forgiveness and pleasure of their Lord. كَمَنْ هُوَ خَالِدٌ فِي النَّارِ وَسُقُوا مَاءً حَمِيمًا فَقَطَّعَ مَعَهُمْ Is there any comparison between all of this as to the one who is in the hellfire, وَسُقُوا And they're given to drink مَاءً حَمِيمًا Boiling hot water. And these people are in the hellfire and their organs are cut up from it. So is there a comparison between this and between that? So these are four rivers of Jannah that are mentioned. The river of water, milk, honey, and wine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to drink from these rivers. There's also a river that is exclusive to the shuhada, for the martyrs. According to many scholars, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the shuhada, the martyrs, are in a green dome beside the river of Bariq, the river of Bariq, near the gate of paradise, from which provision comes to the morning and evening. Now this river could be exclusively for the shuhada, or it could be that they're enjoying this river until the day of resurrection. And so that when they come back and the people enter paradise in their bodies and their souls, maybe other people will be allowed to drink from this river as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. So you'll see rivers all over paradise. And you can try whatever river you want. And these rivers all originate from the center and top of paradise, which is Jannatul Firdaus, the highest levels or gardens of paradise. And then you'll notice that there are also springs in paradise. There are beautiful springs in paradise. إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي ظِلَالٍ وَعُيُونَ Verily, al-muttaqun, the righteous, they shall be amidst shades and springs. They shall be amidst shades and springs. The first of the springs we want to mention is the spring of Kafur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا From a spring that is called Kafur or labeled as Kafur. عَيْنَ يَشْرَبُ بِهَا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ يُفَجِّرُونَهَا تَفْجِيرًا This is a spring wherefrom the slaves of Allah will drink, causing it to gush forth abundantly. Another of the springs of paradise is the spring of Tasneem. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this as well. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ Verily the righteous will be in delight. They will be in paradise. They will be reclining back on their thrones, looking at everything on their chairs or thrones. تَعْرِفُ فِي وُجُوهِهِمْ نَضْرَةَ النَّعِيمِ You'll see in their faces the brightness of happiness. يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيقٍ مَخْتُومٍ They will be given to drink pure, sealed wine. خِتَامُهُ مِسْكُ The end of which will have the smell of misk, a beautiful type of paradise smell of misk. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ And in that and for that, let the competitors compete. Let those who want to race for paradise, race for paradise. وَمِزَاجُهُ مِنْ تَسْنِيمٍ And that wine will be mixed with something called tasneem. عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا الْمُقَرَّبُونَ It's a spring whereof drink those who are nearest to Allah. So another one is tasneem. A third type of spring is the spring of paradise that is called Salsabil. Some scholars believe it's the same as the other, as the Kafur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. وَيُسْقَوْنَ فِيهَا كَأْسًا كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا زَنْجَبِيلًا عَيْنًا فِيهَا تُسَمَّى سَلْسَبِيلًا They will be given a drink. They will be given a drink that contains wine mixed with a type of ginger, the ginger of paradise. A spring therein called Salsabil. So this is another type of spring of paradise. So you see these springs. You see these beautiful rivers of paradise. You see these plains of paradise. And you see that there are palaces and tents in paradise. And so you're not going to be sleeping on the floor of Jannah. Rather, you're going to have a palace or a house, something amazing in paradise, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِيَ الْأَنْهَارِ Allah promised the believing men and women, gardens beneath which rivers flow. وَمَسَاكِنَ طَيِّبَةً فِي جَنَّاتِ عَدْ And they will have beautiful mansions in gardens of everlasting bliss. وَرِضْوَانُ مِنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ And the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is even greater. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ This is the greatest attainment that they can have. Now the people who are in paradise, Allah describes some of these houses and some of these rooms as غُرُفَات. So Allah says, لَكِنِ الَّذِينَ اتَّقُوا رَبَّهُمْ Regarding those who fear their Lord, لَهُمْ غُرَفٌ مِّن فَوْقِهَا غُرَفٌ مَبْنِيَّةٌ They will have rooms, and above them will be another lofty room and another lofty room built upon one another, تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِيَ الْأَنْهَارِ Beneath which rivers flow. وعد الله لا يخلف الله الميعاد. This is the promise of Allah, and Allah does not fail to fulfill His promise. Jibreel came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O Messenger of Allah, Khadija is coming. He's telling him Khadija is coming, and she's carrying a container of food. When she comes to you, convey to her your greetings. Convey to her the greetings of peace from Allah and from me. Allah is giving salam to Khadija. May Allah be pleased with her. So he said, convey to her the greetings of peace from Allah and from me, and give her the glad tidings of a house in paradise made of brocade, in which there is no noise or exhaustion. There is no noise or exhaustion. And this is reported by Imam Bukhari rahimahullah. Imam Muslim reports that the Prophet ﷺ said, I entered paradise where I saw the wife of Abu Talha, and I heard footsteps, and I asked, who is that? And Jibreel said, that is Bilal. And I saw a palace with women in the courtyard, and I asked, whose palace is this? They said, this is for Umar al-Khattab. The Prophet ﷺ said, I wanted to go inside and look at it, but I remembered your jealousy, O Umar, where women are concerned. Umar has jealousy over his woman, meaning his sister, his mom, his whatever. He has jealousy over them. This is how a real man is towards the woman in his life. And then Umar al-Khattab said, may my mother and father be sacrificed for you, O Messenger of Allah. Would I ever feel jealous from you? I would never feel jealous from you. Imam Ahmad reports that the Prophet ﷺ said, whoever builds a masjid for Allah, even if it is as small as a nestling place, scratched out by the bird for its eggs, something tiny even, Allah will build a house for him in paradise. You build something for the sake of Allah, Allah will build something better for you in paradise. Now if a human being comes to you, the richest human being in the world, comes to you and says, I'm going to give you a house, you're more likely to assume that the house is going to be a nice house, the richest person in the world. What if Allah tells you He'll build you a house? That will be a house like no other, a palace like no other. There's no comparison between what Allah gives and between what the creation gives. Now, there's one action item we can add here before we take a break. This is the action item of praying 12 rak'ahs. The action item of praying 12 rak'ahs, the sunan, praying these with your obligatory prayers. The Prophet ﷺ said, whoever prays the 12 rak'ahs, the voluntary rak'ahs every day, Allah will build for him a house in Jannah. And this is reported by Imam Muslim and others. So before Fajr, pray 2 rak'ahs, before the morning prayer, only 2 rak'ahs. Before Dhuhr, 4 rak'ahs. After Dhuhr, 2 rak'ahs, or 4 according to some. Before Dhuhr, 4, after Dhuhr, 2. After Maghrib, 2, and after Isha, 2. These 12 rak'ahs, if you pray them, Allah will build for you a house in Jannah. What kind of house? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But you can be assured that if Allah is building you a palace, it will be something amazing. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us many palaces in paradise. We're going to take a short break inshallah ta'ala, and we'll be right back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Scale of justice will be broke before man.
Huda TV is pleased to announce the launching of its first mobile phone application on all iOS and Android-based devices. Browse your phone store for our new app under the name of Huda TV. Huda app delivers a bunch of amazing and versatile services to our fans and viewers worldwide. You can watch our live streaming on the move, surf our large archive of categorized articles, benefit from our daily supplications, Askar, that every Muslim should recite throughout the day. Just tap on any item of the Askar list and it will take you to the specific supplication it indicates to. Need to know the broadcast time of your favorite program? Just click to broadcast schedule for specific details. Huda app allows users to browse the gems of Huda TV website, where they can enjoy our telemedia services by watching thousands of video clips, plenty of audio clips featuring invocations, nasheeds, and audio themes of our favorite programs. Go back to the index page and check upon what is going on at Huda TV by visiting ever-updated Huda News. Get to know the profiles of Huda stars and never forget to tap on our behind the scenes button for exploring our backstage activities. It's also worthy to check upon Huda's pages on social media websites and enjoy our awesome posts and sharing. Download Huda TV's app now and live our world of authentic Islamically themed educational knowledge. Huda TV brings light to every smartphone.
I was wondering, can I ask you a question?
Be my guest.
Can I make ijtihad on my own? Is takfir an Islamic concept? Are Salafis a sect? Do I have to give da'wah to people? And is interfaith dialogue haram?
Akhi, this is not one question. These are important topics and issues that require we sit and discuss them, inshallah, thoroughly.
Actually, why don't you guys join us for these discussions on contemporary Islamic issues and concepts?
Justice will be brought before man.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back from the break. Before we took a short break, we started talking about the beautiful descriptions of paradise. So you'll see the rivers of paradise, you'll see the springs of paradise, you see the palaces and the mansions of paradise and the rooms of paradise. And you see all of these things and more and more and more. And so the people of paradise, will they see light in Jannah? Will there be darkness in paradise? Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah says, the scholars say that there is no night and there is no day in Jannah. Rather, they will be placed in eternal, everlasting light, nur. They will know when night comes because the curtains or the screens will be put up and the doors will be closed of the houses and mansions and palaces. And they will know when the daytime comes because the curtains or the screens will be taken down and the doors will be opened. And this is mentioned by some scholars of the past. On the same subject, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, there is no sun, there is no moon in paradise, there is no day and there is no night. So the people won't have anything to know these things by. But they will know the morning and the evening from a light that shines from the direction of the throne of Allah. And this is the opinion of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. Does paradise have a smell? Paradise is filled with a beautiful smell. Imam Ahmad reports that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever kills a man of a certain type of people living under Islamic rule, those non-Muslims living under Islamic protection, this person will not smell the fragrance of paradise. The one who commits the killing, they will not smell the fragrance of paradise, even though its fragrance can be smelled from a distance of 40 years traveling, from so far away because of how beautiful it is. The fragrance of Jannah is something we cannot imagine. Furthermore, we mentioned previously that one of the types of people who will not smell the fragrance of paradise is the one who does not have protective jealousy over the woman in his life. So over his wife, over his daughters, his sisters, his mother. So the kind of man that shows off his wife, shows off his mother, shows off his sisters, doesn't want to protect them from the eyes of the people who are gazing at them inappropriately or from people doing things with them inappropriately. This kind of man is a dayyuth. And this person, this kind of man will not be looked at by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And according to one opinion, they won't be able to smell the fragrance of paradise. Now, as you're exploring paradise, you notice these rivers and springs, and we're adding more things as we're describing more things. Then you'll start to notice the plants of paradise. You will notice the trees and the fruits of paradise. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the trees and the fruits are of many kinds, many types, and they are everlasting. إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازَ حَدَائِقَ وَعَنَابَ. Verily for the righteous there will be success, paradise. They will have gardens and grape yards, as one example. فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانٌ. In both of these two gardens, everyone will have these two gardens. In both of them, you'll find fruits and date palms and pomegranates. In another one, it was mentioned there are unlimited fruits, unlimited things, because paradise cannot run out. Paradise cannot run out. It wouldn't be paradise if it ran out. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَأَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينِ مَا أَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينِ. Verily, those of the right hand will be those of the right hand. فِي سِدْرٍ مَخْضُودٍ وَطَلْحٍ مَنْضُودٍ وَظِلٍ مَمْدُودٍ وَمَاءٍ مَسْكُوبٍ. So these people, they will have among them a beautiful type of tree. And these people will have the talh tree with fruits piled one above the other. And they will have shade that is long extended. And they will have water that is flowing constantly. And fruit that is in plenty. وَمَاءٍ مَسْكُوبٍ وَفَاكِهَةٍ كَثِيرًا. Many, countless types of fruits. لَا مَقْطُوعَةٍ وَلَا مَمْنُوعَةٍ. It will not be cut off or prevented for anyone. And it will never run out. It will never run out. So these are not fruits that would run out. Can you imagine if you entered and you ate some fruit and they ran out? Paradise is perfection. This life is limited. And so these people will be enjoying paradise. They'll be enjoying the fruits of Jannah. وَفَاكِهَةٍ مِمَّا يَتَخَيَّرُونَ. Any fruit you can imagine, anything you can desire, you select it. Just take whatever you want. Take any fruit that you want. You're sitting there and the fruits come to you. You think of a fruit, the fruit appears to you. You take the fruit and you eat the fruit, and there's more fruits everywhere. And every bite you take is better than the last bite. May Allah grant us the ability to enjoy the fruits of paradise. Now, in paradise, the description of paradise is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us that which our hearts desire. Our hearts desire. So everything that you want. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُطَافُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِصِحَافٍ مِّنْ ذَهَبٍ وَأَكْوَابٍ. Trays of gold and cups will be passed around them to drink from. وَفِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي الْأَنفُسِ وَتَلَذُّ الْأَعْيُنِ. And these people will have in paradise everything that the soul can desire and everything that the eyes can delight in. They will just make you absolutely happy. وَأَنْتُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. And you will stay there in forever. You'll never lose this happiness. You'll never come back to this life and deal with this misery and hardship and pain again. You will never feel sadness again. Your youth will never fade. Your happiness will only increase. وَفَاكِهَةٍ كَثِيرًا. Many fruits. Constantly, unlike the fruits of this world. So the seasons don't run out, the supply doesn't run out. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides this for the believers. So the people of Jannah, كُلَّمَا رُزِقُوا مِنْهَا مِنْ ثَمَرَةٍ رِزْقًا قَالُوا هَذَا الَّذِي رُزِقْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِ وَأُتُوا بِهِ مُتَشَابِهًا. So every time they're given fruit in Jannah, imagine this, they will say, this is what we were given from before. This is what we were provided with before. And they will be given glad tidings in resemblance, in the same form but different in taste. So every time they eat, it's as if this is something brand new. The taste is even better. And the fruits of the trees will be low hanging and they will be near. They will be easy to reach. مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَىٰ فُرُشٍ بَطَائِنُهَا مِنْ إِسْتَبْرَقٍ وَجَنَى الْجَنَّتَيْنِ دَانٍ. Reclining upon the couches or the thrones of Jannah, lined with silver brocade, you'll have the fruits of the two gardens nearby. Nearby, you can reach for them anytime you want. And then you'll notice around Jannah, aside from just the fruits, you'll see the trees of paradise. You'll see the trees of paradise. Now my brothers and sisters, one of the trees of Jannah is so large, so big, that it takes 100 years to cross the shade of this tree, to ride across. The Prophet ﷺ spoke about this tree. He said, in paradise there is a tree in which the rider of a very fast horse would need 100 years to pass beneath. This is reported by Imam al-Bukhari. He said, in paradise, there's a tree under whose shade a traveler can travel for 100 years and not reach the edge of it. It was reported by Imam Muslim. This tree is huge and it's a beautiful tree. Now there's another tree that's mentioned that most scholars say is the same exact tree. It is called the tree of Tuba. The tree of Tuba. So the Prophet ﷺ said, Tuba is a tree in paradise. It is a tree in Jannah. It is as big as 100 years journey. It takes 100 years to ride across. The clothes of the people of Jannah are made from the calluses, the outer parts of its flowers. This is an authentic hadith. The clothes of the people of Jannah are made from this amazing, amazing divine tree created for paradise. The Prophet ﷺ, a man came to him and asked him a question. He said, O Messenger of Allah, tell us about the clothes of the people of Jannah. Are they created or are they woven? Some of the people laughed. The Prophet ﷺ said, why are you laughing? Because someone who does not know is asking someone who knows. He said, don't laugh at someone when they have questions. And this is from the etiquette. Somebody asks a question. Don't laugh at it because they might be serious about it. Don't humiliate them or belittle them. So when someone asks a question, you might know the answer or you might feel like it's not important, but don't laugh at people. People want, you know, these answers. Let them have this. Let them have this. Don't destroy people's esteem. So the Prophet ﷺ turned and asked, where's the man that asked this question? The man said, here I am, O Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, no. The clothes of the people of Jannah are produced by the fruits of paradise, meaning by the trees of paradise. And this is the tree of Tuba. There's also the tree that we've heard of before, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to it in Surah Al-Najm. وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ نَزْلَةً أُخْرَى. And he saw him, he saw Jibreel alayhi salam in another descent. عِنْدَ سِدْرَةِ الْمُنْتَهَى. The low tree of the utmost boundary, beyond which nobody can pass. عِنْدَهَا جَنَّةُ الْمَأْوَى. Near it is the paradise of abode. So this tree is Sidrat al-Muntaha, and it was mentioned more than one time. Al-Bukhari reports that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about this tree, one of the leaves of this tree could cover the entire ummah. It was veiled in colors indescribable. Can you imagine somebody asking you, what color did you see in Jannah? What color was that tree? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, its colors are indescribable. You cannot begin to describe the colors. Our colors are limited in this world, meaning there is something in Jannah beyond which we can imagine. SubhanAllah. May Allah grant us the highest levels of paradise. Paradise also has the best aromatic plants. The best aromatic plants. فَرَوْحٌ وَرَيْحَانٌ وَجَنَّةُ نَعِيمٌ. There is for this person rest and provision. Raihan literally means a sweet smelling plant. Here it's used as a symbolical thing of satisfaction and delight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this. the trunks of the trees of paradise. You'll go up to these trunks to explore them. What is this tree made out of? The Prophet ﷺ said, there is no tree in Jannah that does not have a trunk that is made out of gold. Furthermore, the Prophet ﷺ told us how to increase our trees in paradise. Do you want more of these trees in your gardens? So the Prophet ﷺ said, I met Ibrahim ﷺ. What did Ibrahim say to the Prophet ﷺ? He said, O Muhammad, tell your ummah that paradise is a land whose soil is good and its water is sweet. It is an empty plain which will be planted with Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, and Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, and Allahu Akbar. The plants of paradise. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. These are the treasures of paradise. My dear brothers and sisters, wet your tongue with the remembrance of Allah all the time. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, la ilaha illa Allahu Akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and plant your trees in paradise. As for the animals and the birds of Jannah, وَلَحْمِ طَيْرٍ مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ. They will have to eat from the flesh of any kind of bird that they desire, any kind of fowl that they desire. So the Prophet ﷺ was asked about Al-Kawthar, and we mentioned before that he said, there are birds drinking from it. Their necks are like the necks of camels. So Umar said, these birds are going to be in bliss. They're going to be happy. The Prophet ﷺ said, those who eat those birds will be even more blissful. The people in Jannah eating these things are going to be even more happy. Now, somebody once came to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, this camel, I'm donating it for the sake of Allah. So he said, you will have 700 camels in paradise, as was reported by Al-Hakim. 700 camels in paradise. So there are animals in paradise. People want animals, they love animals, they will have them in paradise. And the last thing we want to mention is very, very beautiful. Somebody came to the Prophet ﷺ, he asked a very interesting question. He said, O Messenger of Allah, are there horses in paradise? The Prophet ﷺ said, if Allah admits you to paradise, any time you wish to be carried on a horse made out of red rubies that will fly with you wherever you want in paradise, you can do so. A horse made out of red rubies to fly across paradise, you can have that. You will be able to do that. Somebody else came and asked the Prophet ﷺ, O Messenger of Allah, will there also be camels in paradise? The Prophet ﷺ didn't give him the same response. Rather, he said, if Allah admits you to paradise, you will have there whatever your heart desires. Ya Allah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the most beautiful gardens and levels of paradise. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the highest levels of paradise. My dear brothers and sisters, wet your tongue with the remembrance of Allah. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Always wet your tongue with the remembrance of Allah. Always mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always work for paradise. Make dua for paradise. Do what you can to reach paradise. My dear brothers and sisters, do not give up or sacrifice your eternity, eternal bliss,